Today I will show you my prototype of my RFID locking system. What you see here is a deadbolt lock. It's currently activated and it uses a magnet to detect when you close the door, and then it will activate. After it is a breadboard, which I use to prototype with an Arduino Tiny on it, an RFID reader and some tags. And I got all this stuff from Deal Extreme, so it's very cheap and it works very well. And I'm going to use this to lock my garden door with these RFID tags. Well, this is the first node. I'm going to make multiple nodes that connect by network and make some home automation project of it. So I'm not only going to be able to lock my garden door, but also the rest of my house. I will do a short demonstration now. I have a key here that I already have learned to the system. So when I scan it, the system unlocks and waits a while, and then it will lock again, or you can lock it manually. We have one feedback LED. This is this one. So there will be a LED outside at the door. If it's locked, then it will stay on most of the time, but blink a little bit, kind of like a heartbeat. And if it's unlocked, then it stays off most of the time, but still blinks some a little bit to show that the system is online and powered on. So how to add new keys and how to remove keys? Well, there are two special keys for that. One is the administrator key, and one is the clear all key. When we use the clear all key, the system forgets about all the keys it knows, so you can no longer use the keys anymore. It doesn't forget all the keys, it forgets all the normal keys, except for these two special keys, which are the administrator key and the clear all key. Well, so now we've cleared these two keys, and if we want to add a key again, then we have to use the administrator key. And when we do that, you will see that the light will blink for a very short time, this light. And during that time you can learn it a new key, but you have to be quick. So I'm going to try it now. No, that didn't work. Maybe I should make it a little bit longer, but it works. And now I've learned this key. And this key, of course, still doesn't work like it should. So this is basically how the system works. I will put in a link below with to my GitHub account to the source code of this project. So if you're interested in more info, then please leave a note and maybe I can put up some schematics. But I know that there are hundreds of people doing stuff like this on the internet, so it's not very special, but I wanted to show anyway. All right, thank you.